We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of baseball on MLB Network. It's game three of the National League Division Series between the Chicago Cubs and the Colorado Rockies. Now at the plate, Chris Bryant, and we are set for baseball here this evening. Fastball in there, 3-2. But we might be ice skating before we're through tonight. 39 degrees at first pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Anthony Rizzo stands in now. Previous history with Herman Marquez, batting 500, 4-for-8. He's taken him deep once. A ball and two strikes to Anthony Rizzo. A knuckle curve there, and he thought he had him, but it's 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to Rizzo. That misses, so the count goes full now to the second batter of the ball game.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2, but when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Anthony Rizzo goes down for out number two in the top half. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in, Kevin Pillar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 1-1 on its way from Lester. High and deep down the left field line. And that's going to land foul. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And up steps Garrett Hampson to bat. A 1-1 home. Trying to bunt his way on, but this is popped up. Bryant is there, and he has it for the out. Striding in for the Rockies, Charlie Blackmon looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Lester gets the sign, coming home with the 1-1 pitch. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
Made him look silly with that one.
And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
Two pitch mix here. If you're in the batter's box, you're looking for something up.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Kyle Schwarber. The 2-2. And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. Ready now with the payoff pitch. And that misses for ball four. So it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. A strike to Contreras, and it's 1-1. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. Into the bleachers and gone.
Pitchers aren't going to throw this guy much of a fastball to try to challenge him because this guy can hit him a mile just like he did with that swing right there. Impressive power.
Into the box, Jason Hayward. And it's fouled away. Now the payoff pitch home. There's a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Here's Cameron Maben now.
Batting. The designated hitter. Cameron Maben.
The 1-2. This is skied into short left center. Pilar moving in. He gets there, and that's the second out. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. And it's 1-2. Frozen on strike three for the final out of the inning. Bottom of the inning now, and in to hit next, shortstop Trevor Story.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Full count now, 3-2. High and deep to right center. Hayward giving chase. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. So the base is empty here with one away. And in next, it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now. Here's Kipnis now, the second baseman. He's got it, and there's out number two. So stepping in, David Dahl, trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Fouled off. Two out, nobody on. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Hayward has a read on it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Next Cub up, Jason Kipnis, and he'll start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Full count, 3-2. This is hit the other way out toward left field. On the run is Dahl. He makes the catch, a great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. So it's back to the top of the order now. And into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. Lined hard toward right center. A dive, but it's off his glove.
The first baseman, number 44.
At the plate now, Anthony Rizzo, fouled away. And another foul ball. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Back up the middle. Story brings it in. Barehanded for one. On to Murphy. It's a double play, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, Daniel Murphy. And they'll need him to get something going here. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Hey. That's softly hit to right. Will that get down? And there's the first hit of the game for Colorado.
The second baseman, Ryan.
Standing in now, Ryan McMahon. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Drilled to first. And he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. So now to the plate, Dom Nunez. Big swing, but a little dribbler here to the right side of the mound. And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. So striding in, Kevin Pillar, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. A 1-1. Murphy at third. McMahon is over at second with one down in the inning. Still 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him. Next for the Rockies is the DH, Garrett Hampson. 0-1 for him here in this one. Two balls and a strike.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
On the ground for Kipnis. This could be two. Fielded cleanly. The second for one. Throw on to first. Won't be in time, so they just get the one there. In now for Colorado, Charlie Blackmon, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Payoff pitch on its way. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. And now they've got him in a rundown. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. All set for the start of the fourth. And with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Looking up is Dahl. Gone to lead off the inning. Stepping in now, Kyle Schwarber. Base is empty here with nobody out. Still 2-2.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Kyle Schwarber becomes the first out of the inning. 2-2 to the Cubs catcher.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Grounder down the line at third. Here's another 2-2. A little too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. The lefty Jason Hayward waits in the on-deck circle. Bouncer up the middle. Scorey picks it up on to first, and there are two down. So that'll bring up Jason Hayward. He's 0-1 thus far. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Line hard to center field. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran outfielder, Charlie Blackmon.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Taken in by Kipnis, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Trevor Story. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. But this guy's big pack.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Schwarber is back to the track as he takes it for out number two. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. One run, two hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Hasn't seen a heater yet in this at-bat. One might be coming right here.
And he missed again, high and away this time, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left. Lester's ready. Here comes the 3-2. Line towards center field. Hap will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. So in now for Chicago, Cameron Maben comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Hit hard on the ground to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Digging in, the switch hitter, Ian Happ. First time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
Happ with a 2-1 count now. Now a hard liner. But this is a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And that is off the wall. Around second now and headed for third. The relay throw, but he is in there with a triple. In now, Jason Kipnis. Line hard toward right center. And this is going to split the fairway and head out toward the rock pile for extra bases. As he arrives at second without a play, as a run will score on the play as well. Into the box now, Chris Bryant to short. Throw to Murphy's in time, and there are two gone now. So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Anthony Rizzo. Working for the punch-out and the offering. Line drive, base hit. And the runner at third will put the brakes on here as they didn't want to chance it even with two outs. At the plate now, Javier Baez. Leaps and makes a terrific catch, and with that, the side is retired. Digging in for his second at bat, David Dahl, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Makes him swing and miss on a ball out of the zone for strike two.
That's been a great pitch for him all night. Able to push and pull the throttle a little bit, throwing a good fastball located and mixing in that nasty changeup with good arm action.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. David Dahl is retired for the first out in the bottom half of the fifth. And he fouls this one off. Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. Throw gets him, two down. So bases are empty here with two gone. And Ryan McMahon digs into bat next. A Ball and two strikes, the count to Ryan McMahon.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Hit out towards second. And that is through into center field, a base hit. The throw into second. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Chichi Gonzalez takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
For the Rockies, number 50, Chichi Gonzalez.
Into the box, Kyle Schwarber. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras, a hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Good change of speeds, but he lays off 2-1. And it's fouled away. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. Slap hard the opposite way. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he's in there easily at second with a one out double.
Now batting the right fielder, Jason Hayward.
To the plate now, Jason Hayward, hit in the air down the right field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Payoff pitch one more time. Pulled toward right center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And this one scoots all the way to the wall. He pulls into third safely. As also on the play, a run comes across to score.
The batter, number 15, designated hitter.
Stepping in now, Cameron Maben. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. It's 6-1. So now to the plate, Ian Happ. Step on the bag for one. Murphy with a dive. Throw back to second, and they've got him doubled off, and the inning is over. Settling in now, Dom Nunez. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Here's the 1-1.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
In there, and it's full 3-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Kevin Pillar. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch.
Yeah, Matty, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
And he'll flip it over to Lester for the out. And that'll bring in Garrett Hampson. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. The 1-2. And a good pitch there as this ball swung on and popped straight up the chute right around home plate. Contreras is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. And is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. And this is sliced hard down the left field line. And a perfect start to the seventh, as this should be extra bases. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out. Jairo Diaz comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number 7.
Ryan.
Into the box now, Chris Bryant. And he missed with it here, so now it's a full count, 3-2. Waiting next is Anthony Rizzo. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Number 44.
And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave it.
He throws him on the breaking ball that time. Anthony Rizzo goes down for the first out in the seventh inning. Liner towards second. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And that's going to plate the runner from second, and it's now a 7-1 game.
Now back.
At the plate, Kyle Schwarber. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. Gone. And that one had some extra distance. Yency Almonte enters now in a mop-up role as she'll try to keep the deficit right where it is. Standing in now, Wilson Contreras. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang. Here's Jason Hayward now.
The right fielder, Jason Hayward.
Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there.
He drilled the previous batter, and now he falls behind 3-1 to this guy. The last thing you can do, though, is throw a fastball middle of the plate right here.
Now he goes the other way, and he got a lot of it high and deep to left center field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he's in safely at third, as a run will score on the play as well.
The batter, number 15, designated hitter, Cameron.
In now, Cameron Maben. Sharp ground ball to third. Oh, look at the sliding stop. Got him. Ready once again, Ian Happ. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Men on third with two down. Weak grounder back to the mound. Story scoops it up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Charlie Blackmon.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
All even now, 2-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Drilled on the ground is short. Baez fields it cleanly, throws in time, and that's out number one. And that brings in the power hitting shortstop, Trevor Story. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked a guy up with it.
To two balls and two strikes now. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four. Coming to the plate now, Nolan Arenado. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. The 3-1. This is line to left, and that's in there. Base hit.
Now back, left fielder, David.
To the plate now, David Dahl. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, the Rockies have been looking for that big hit all game long. They haven't been able to come through so far, but now would be the time to come through.
And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Ready for another shot now. Daniel Murphy, two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. The 2-1. High in the air, carrying well out to deep center. Going back is the center fielder. Way gone. Out to the tree farm. So now to the plate, Ryan McMahon. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Lester's ready. Here's the pitch. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Fouled off. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And the sinker runs too low here as he loses him. It's ball four. Dan Winkler takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. Dom Nunez will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. Here's the 1-1. And that fastball's too much for him there. 1-2. That's lifted the other way out to left. Schwarber is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Ready to begin the eighth, and standing in now, the power-hitting second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Now the 1-1 pitch. This pitch is popped up. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Here's Chris Bryant now. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
This guy has been unbelievable. There were billboards outside Wrigley while he was still in AAA, and what does he do when he shows up? Rookie of the year, MVP. I mean, get in line.
Base hit into right center. Into the box, Anthony Rizzo. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Runners are at first and second with one away. Into the corner and slicing foul.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off of it.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. Ashton Godot comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Kyle Schwarber will be the first to meet him here, and he'll do so in an enviable situation indeed. Bases loaded and only one out now. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Dunn has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And even with two outs now, they decide to hold that runner at third. In now, Wilson Contreras. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Two out, bases loaded. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Jason Adam is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 60, Jason.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Kevin Pillar. Two and one, the count to Pillar. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Baez ranging to his right, and there's one away. Stepping in, Garrett Hampson, 0 for 3 with an RBI in this one. Four runs, five hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Rockies thus far. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
Now
into the box now, Charlie Blackmon. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Though next it'll be the number 4 batter for the Rockies, Trevor Story, 0 for 2 for him to this point. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted high and deep into the bleachers and out of here. At the plate, Nolan Arenado. And looked like he jammed him that time a bit as it's hit in the air to center field. Happ will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Jason Hayward. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. The 1-2. Freezes him. A strikeout looking. Digging in to try it again. Cameron Maben. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Maben.
The 1-1 home. He is in there for the second strike. Lays off 2-2 now. Now here's the pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. On the move is Pillar. He gets there, and that's the second out. Now in the box, Ian Happ. He was a ground out victim last time up. A 1-1 home. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. And that misses 2-2. This one's outside. Quite a good off the plate that time. Lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Now batter.
Stepping up to the plate, Jason Kipnis. Two doubles for him to this point in the game. The 1-1.
And when you're already down 5, the last thing you want to do is fall behind in the count when you're on the mound. That's not going to do anything to help you get back into this thing.
Bounce to first. Gloved by Murphy, and as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Kyle Ryan, a 6'5" left-hander, takes over on the mound now. Striding in to start the ninth, David Dahl, and they'll need him to get something going here. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Through first and hustling for second. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out. And now Daniel Murphy back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Pat picks it up. The runner scores from second. Stepping in now, Ryan McMahon. And there's ball two now. A runner at first with no outs here. He pulls this one into right. And another base hit for him. Now 3-for-3 in this one. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Rowan Wick takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door. Standing in now, Dom Nunez. Got him. Fooled on the pitch as he swings at it in the dirt for strike three. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Kevin Pillar. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. The 1-1 pitch.
Great pitch right there. That is a huge breaking ball. Not shocked he took it. Got to calibrate that one for a second.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Number one.
Two men are on with two men out. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
Well, this is a big pitch right here. Two outs in the ninth. The last thing you want to do is walk a guy and bring the tying run to the plate.
Taken called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Last strike now for Colorado. Now he tries to hold back on the swing, and the home plate umpire says he did so successfully. It's ball four. Now at the plate, Charlie Blackmon struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. And a fly ball, and this should do it. Long run for the center fielder, and the Cubs are one step closer. They're going to the National League Championship Series.
Well, my advice to them is to enjoy this moment, celebrate with teammates, and then realize that none of it will matter if they don't get back to work in the NLCS. They've wet their beaks with this postseason success. Now they want some more.
Well, the lineup was clicking for him in this contest, and the man you see there was a major contributor. For that, he's the Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he really made it happen with the bat in this one. You see here, two hits, and one was a long ball, so he has to feel pretty good about what he did here.
For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our hardworking crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been the National League Division Series.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 11 runs on 14 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners on base.